Now, what about the question of evolution? Let me submit to you that this is a complete red herring. The theory of evolution is irrelevant to the truth of the Christian faith. Genesis 1 permits all manner of different interpretations, and Christians are not necessarily committed to special creationism. Howard Van Til of Calvin College, a Christian school, asks, is the concept of special creation required of all persons who trust in the Creator God of Scripture? Most Christians in my acquaintance who are engaged in either scientific or biblical scholarship have concluded that the special creationist picture of the world's formation is not a necessary component of Christian belief. And I want to emphasize this is not a retreat caused by modern science. St. Augustine, in the 300s, in his commentary on Genesis, argued that the days needn't be taken literally, nor need the creation be a few thousand years ago. He didn't even envisage special acts of creation. He said the world could have been made by God with certain potencies that unfolded in the progress of time. This interpretation was enunciated 1,500 years prior to Darwin, and therefore this is a position that's consistent with being a Christian. Any doubts that I might have about the theory of evolution really are not biblical but scientific. Namely, what the scenario envisages is just so fantastically improbable. In their book, The Anthropic Cosmological Principle, Barrow and Tipler lay out 10 steps necessary to the course of human evolution, each of which is so improbable that before it would occur, the sun would have ceased to be a main sequence star and would have burned up the earth. Now, it seems to me that if evolution did occur, then it would have had to have been a miracle. In other words, evolution is literally evidence for the existence of God. In fact, the Christian has an advantage over the atheist here. We can be open to what the evidence shows us. But as Alvin Plantinga points out, for the atheist, you see, evolution is the only game in town. So he's stuck with it, no matter how fantastic the odds, no matter how poor the evidence, he's got no choice. But the Christian can be open to follow the evidence where it leads, and therefore, I think, can be more objective.